Hello, I'm Dr. David Velkoff, Medical Director of the Drake Institute of Neurophysical Medicine. In this presentation, I'm going to explain how to tell if attention deficit symptoms are more likely coming from ADHD or possibly from anxiety, sometimes from even both disorders, and how to best treat the patient. ADHD and anxiety both cause attentional problems, poor focusing. So successful treatment depends on identifying which disorder with its abnormal brainwave functioning is causing the problem. There are questions you can immediately ask your child to help understand if one is more likely suffering primarily from ADHD or from anxiety. First, is your child a worrier, or do worrisome thoughts make it more difficult for them to complete tasks? Are they scared or nervous about going to school? Do they feel homesick? Is there a family history of anxiety? Is either parent being treated for anxiety? If the answer to these questions is yes, then the attentional problems your child is having could be coming from an anxiety disorder, or even from generalized anxiety disorder. These children have poor focusing because their minds are being dominated with anxious, worrisome thoughts that block them and prevent them from focusing on task. A teacher or a parent may notice that a child with an anxiety disorder just seems emotionally uncomfortable, ill at ease, regardless of whether they have to focus and complete a task or not. So in this scenario, we're much more likely to diagnose a child with an anxiety disorder causing the focusing problem, and we're going to treat the anxiety first. In contrast, a child with ADHD inattentive presentation may only show anxiety with academic tasks. Otherwise, their minds are calm, quiet, but become easily distracted when focusing on non-preferred tasks, which results in the inattention. Parents of an ADHD inattentive child will frequently tell us that my child is not an anxious child, unless they're struggling sometimes with non-preferred tasks. So in this scenario, we're more likely to diagnose ADHD inattentive presentation, and we're going to treat the ADHD first with neurofeedback. It can get somewhat complicated because ADHD will cause secondary anxiety in some children, and anxiety certainly can worsen ADHD, and stimulant drugs for ADHD may also worsen anxiety. To treat ADHD and anxiety, we use brain map guided neurofeedback. We have found it the most clinically successful treatment in helping ADHD and anxiety. The protocols we use were developed from over 30 years of our successfully helping our patients. So to best understand of how to treat the patient, we first have to analyze brain functioning. If I walk in the emergency room and I've got chest pain, the doctors are gonna do an electrocardiogram, an EKG of my heart. They wanna see how my heart's working so they can figure out what's going on and how to best treat me. It's no different in the brain. If you have ADHD or anxiety, your symptoms are coming from the brain. So it's common sense. We wanna analyze brain functioning first so we can develop out the most effective treatment. So in analyzing brain functioning, we utilize functional neuroimaging with quantitative EEG or EEG brain mapping that can identify if any regions or networks in the brain are not regulating normally linked to symptoms of ADHD or anxiety. A qEEG brain map is a window in discovering how the brain is functioning. This first image is a lateral view of the right side of the brain. This next image is a qEEG brain map showing the right side of the brain in a child with ADHD inattentive presentation. The blue color is showing areas of the brain that are deficient and low in beta-fast brainwave activity that is essential and necessary to sustain focus concentration. The low beta brainwave activity causes underactivation of the brain and a reduced capacity to be able to focus. So no wonder this child struggles with paying attention in class or struggles with homework where their parent has to be checking on them all the time. No color on the brain map is actually normal. Now, this next brain map is a qEEG of a patient with anxiety. utilizing a different QEEG brain map window and analyzing brain functioning. With anxiety in children, you will see frequently the brain is actually overstimulated, it's overactivated. In medicine, if an organ is overactivated, it's going to malfunction. For example, if your thyroid's overactivated, you can have hyperthyroid disease. If your blood sugar is too high, you could be hyperglycemic. If a muscle is overactivated, it could spasm or cramp. Well, guess what? Your brain also can malfunction if it's overactivated. The red color in the beta fast brainwave frequency is reflecting overactivation of the brain or an unhealthy hypervigilance. This pattern is associated with racing thoughts, anxiety, difficulty sleeping, emotional overreactivity, as well as inability to focus clearly. Although both these patients are suffering with attention problems, they're caused by completely different mechanisms. In the child with ADHD, their brain is underactivated. In the child with anxiety, their brain is actually overactivated. So to successfully treat the child, neurofeedback protocols must be custom tailored to address and target and improve the specific dysregulation causing the inattention problems in each patient. For the ADHD patient, we're going to design neurofeedback protocols to actually increase beta fast brainwave activities, enabling the child to focus and concentrate more normally. In contrast with our anxiety patient, we're going to develop out neurofeedback protocols to actually decrease the excessive abnormal fast brainwave activity that's driving their anxiety and their racing, distracting thoughts. For patients with both disorders, which we see sometimes, we're going to treat the most troublesome symptom first. Even if your child has ADHD, but they're being dominated with anxiety, we're going to treat the anxiety first. There is an advantage in treating the anxiety first, because if you relieve the anxiety, one's quality of life is going to improve rather quickly. Furthermore, if the anxiety is relieved and the inattention symptoms are relieved at the same time, then it's now clear there never was an underlying ADHD. It was all from anxiety. However, if the anxiety is relieved but the child still has trouble focusing, then we're going to now treat the ADHD-driven inattention with neurofeedback. And with neurofeedback, we're using the brain's own resources, the greatest pharmacy in the world, your own brain, to improve its own functioning to reduce and resolve symptoms. If you found this video helpful, please like the video, and you can subscribe to our YouTube channel. There are going to be more informational videos coming soon. You're also welcome to sign up for our monthly newsletter with the link listed. And if you have questions about ADHD or anxiety as discussed in this video, please leave them in the comment section below. Thank you.